Hello friends, welcome to new tutorial of Sapin blog. In this video, we'll talk about the pollination process in detail. Before moving straight forward to pollination, let us understand various parts of flower and its importance, because they play major role in pollination. So in flower, as you can see, this green part is sepal. At the bottom, this part, it is sepal. It provides support to the developing flower. And here, this colorful part, yellow thing, these are known as petal. They are meant for attraction. Also, they cover the reproductive parts of the flower. Here, as you can see, this big structure, this is ovary. Or we can say that female reproductive part. Female reproductive part, in case of flower, it is known as pistil. Pistil is divided into three categories: stigma, style, and ovary. Stigma, this part, it is meant for reception. Reception of pollen. And this style, it is a long tube which leads towards the ovary, where actually the egg cells are there. And the egg cells, in case of flower, it is known as ovule. After that, you will see the male part. So remember one thing, in case of flower, female part is only one in number. But male part can be many. Here you can see there are four male parts. And male parts, they are known as stamen. They are divided into two structures, anther and filament. So filament is a supporting structure for anther. Anther is like bulby structure. It is like that. In this structure, the pollen tube develops. Pollen grain, I mean, not pollen tube. Here, pollen grain develops. So one anther can contain many pollen grain, because it is a site of development of pollen grain. So it don't develop only one pollen grain at a time. It can develop many at a time. So this stalk and receptacle part, so these also provide the support to developing flower. So that's how plant flower look like. Coming to the pollination again, so let's see what is pollination about. Pollination is nothing but a process in which transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma happens. In case of pollination, so this is the process which is running in the plant so that they can maintain the continuity of species. If pollination does not happen, in that case, the plant will not be able to produce new progeny. So now, in case of pollination, we have two gametes. The one is ovule and another one is pollen. Ovule is female gamete and it resides in ovary. While pollen is a male gamete and it is present in anther. Here, the point to be considered is that in case of pollen, pollen is also immobile. It cannot move on its own because they need external agent so that they can reach the stigma. And those agent can be, these agent can be animals, water, and wind. So this was the brief about the pollination process. Let's move on to the types of pollination that happen in plants. So pollination is broadly classified into two categories. These are basically self-pollination and cross-pollination. So now let us understand the difference in between these two. In case of self-pollination, transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma of genetically similar flower happens. So that means the flowers, they are of same kind in terms of their genetics. So only then the transfer can happen. In case of cross-pollination, it is also known as xenogamy. In this, basically, transfer of pollen from anther to stigma of genetically different flowers. Happen. So basically here two flowers, they are having different genetics, and in between these two the pollination happens. So this type of pollination is known as cross pollination. In case of cross pollination, the best example can be seen in papaya flower. And maize. In case of cell pollination, it can be seen in rice and wheat. So these type of pollination can be observed in these specific types of plant. Let's have a look at these pictures and understand the process in detail. So as you can see, these are two different flowers. So they must be genetically different. That means their genetics will be different. Their genes are placed on different positions. So cross-pollination always require two different types of flower. And here you can see that pollen will reach the stigma part. Here this part is stigma and this is anther. So this is anther. Anther will release the pollen, and pollen by wind here, it will reach the stigma of different flower. And that's how cross-pollination happens. In case of self-pollination, as you can see, the pollen grain is coming from the same stigma of the flower. Pollen grain from same anther, it is moving towards the stigma of same flower. So that's how this process is like. In case of self-pollination, we have two more categories. So let's see that in detail. Self-pollination is basically divided into the two categories. These are autogamy and geitonogamy. So let's see what is the difference in between these two. Here, transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma of same flower happens. This can be seen in pea plant and rice plant. So it is just like that. Let's suppose this is a flower. And in this flower, there is one stigma. And there are some anthers. So let's suppose these are anthers and this is stigma. So here actually what happens? Pollen grain from anther will reach the stigma and it is the same flower only. So we call this process as autogamy. And in case of gitonogamy, here transfer from anther of one flower to stigma of another flower. Of same plant. Happens. So the structure will be like that. So let's suppose if this is a plant and in this plant we have two flowers. Let's suppose this is one flower and this is another flower. Here you can see the anther. So this is anther and on this flower you can see some stigma. So what actually happens here? From anther, pollen grain moves towards the stigma of another flower. So here you can see two flowers of same plant. They are having the pollination in between, right? So this type of thing we can see in examples of gitonogamy can be cucurbita. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, do like, comment, and don't forget to hit on the bell icon.